What's going on, everybody? Welcome to another New Creature Speaks video. I appreciate your support. Okay, if you are interested in following me on Twitter, Facebook, or Google+, please view the information right there at the bottom there in the description, okay? And if you are interested in following other ventures that I have going on, such as Next Era Sports, Next Era Sounds, and more, please view that video, keeping up with New Creature Info updated, 12/30/2014, okay? That's what's going down, and that is located under the New Creature Speaks video channel. I have two video channels going on here, so by the grace of God, you know, you guys just view that video, okay? All the information is there, all right? So let's get into it, because I got a lot to cover here. I titled this video, Don't Be Afraid of Money. Don't be afraid of money, all right? Now, I just want to say to my Christian family, okay, I noticed that there's a fear going on in the body of Christ concerning money, okay? Now, let me just explain to you my position, okay, what Christ has called me to do. My position is to lead Christians into the mainstream, okay? What is mainstream? Be well known to those who aren't Christians so they can be encouraged to become Christians, all right? Now, with that being said, in that area, in that field, there's going to be a channel of money coming towards us. Okay? There's going to be a channel of money coming towards us. All right? And you can't be afraid of it. You cannot be afraid of money coming towards us. People are going to be supporting you or me because we're doing this thing for the Lord Jesus Christ. Okay? There's a scripture in the Word that says, I have not given you the spirit of fear, but of power, love, and of a sound mind. Okay? I've noticed there's a lot of fear going on in the body of Christ concerning money. And Christ wants to give us money because in this earth that we live in, ladies and gentlemen, okay, you're going to need money to live. All right? No matter how you look at it, you're going to need money to live. Pay your rent. Pay all your bills. Mobile bill, your car note or whatever, insurance, all that. And then you got to eat, right? Clothes on your back. You got kids to feed. You got mouths to feed. You understand what I'm saying? And everything. You know what I'm saying? Maintenance on your house, maintenance on your car or what have you. You know? All that stuff. Now, Christ wants to make sure you have money to take care of all that and more. So you can bless somebody else. So they can be, you can help them out. Okay? Yes, we can preach the gospel to them. Okay, but a lot of them are not, they're going to hear the gospel, and that's, you know, that's fine, okay, that's what they're supposed to do, hear the gospel. However, they want to see that they're in a position where they may be in that position of poverty, and they want out of it. So in order for them to be out of it, they got to see examples of Christians who are operating in the prosperity world, okay, in the prosperity field, okay, for Christ. All right. How big is our God? How big is this Christ? How big is this God that you say that you live for? Okay. He's on the streets made of heaven. I mean, made of gold. I'm sorry. He's on streets made of gold. And he wants his children in earth experiencing this prosperity that he's experiencing up there in heaven, down here on earth. So people can be, be encouraged to be, I can have my needs met and above my needs in the body of Christ. Okay. Because a lot of people right now are working hard, 2, 3, 4 jobs a day. When Christ can make it easier for them and say, you know what, you don't have to do that. Just come work for me. You're talking about the Lord now. Come work for me. Come do fulfill your purpose, and I'll take care of you financially. Seek first the kingdom of God and all these righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. You understand what I'm saying? So we got to be those examples. And we can't be afraid of money. If we go to a lot of these churches right now, I'm telling you, if we go to a lot of these churches, there's a spirit of poverty in a lot of these churches. They're not operating in the spirit of prosperity like Christ wants them to operate in. Because how are we supposed to be examples to the world if we don't do that? Okay? And those of us who are doing that, there's going to be another spirit speaking to them saying, don't go to that church because all they want is your money. Okay? Missing the opportunity for them to be blessed by, you know, being in a prosperity church, okay, when they can have their needs met. In order to get your needs met, you got to go to a church that's already got their needs met. You understand what I'm saying? You can't go to a church that don't got their needs met and you expect you'll get your needs met. Okay? It's not gonna work that way. You gotta go to that church, right? They have their needs met already, and it's Christ's design for you to go to that church, get under that pastor, okay, that's already got their needs met. That church already got all their bills paid for, and now you can sit up under that church, and then what they have can come on you. You get what I'm saying? That's how it's supposed to work, okay? But how can they do that if we as Christians are sitting in a level of poverty that Christ can't really do anything? You get what I'm saying? He can't really minister to people, you know? There's people right now saying, you know, at this video probably, saying, well, you know, new creature, I see what you're saying, but, you know, I have to have money, you know, I got bills to pay. You get what I'm saying? Well, we got to be that example to them and say, well, you can get your bills paid, you know, and they can see it. Not just hear it by way of talk. They can see that thing. I want to see it, new creature. That's what I want to see. I want to see it. And they want to say that about you, you know. Yeah, I hear all this God stuff. I hear this Christ stuff that you're talking about, you know what I'm saying? But I want to see it with my own eyes, okay? You have to understand, Christians, the world's not going to see what we see, all right? They don't walk by faith. They walk by sight, okay? We as Christians are the opposite. We walk by what we don't see, so Christ can bring what we don't see into our lives so we can see, okay? We're the spiritual people. We're the ones that got to walk by faith, because the world doesn't see what we see, okay? The world doesn't see what we see as far as the vision that Christ has given me for right now. You get what I'm saying? Some may see, but some may not see, okay? It's a spiritual thing, all right? And what Christ is going to do, he's going to bring that spiritual thing into the natural so people can see, okay? And everything that we live for, you know, we got, it's going to be have to be supported by us. So anyway, back to the prosperity, all right? You got to not be afraid of money, man, okay? I understand you may not understand. The scripture says, you know, with all you're getting, get understanding. And you want to throw stones at me or somebody else because they're teaching money to the church. That is their job, to teach money to the church so the church can get their needs met, okay? If there's no teaching, then there's no reaching, okay? If there's no teaching, then we can't reach anybody, all right? We got to be taught. It's like us babies coming into a family, okay? We're going to have to be taught, all right? We was taught by our parents, right, as we grew, right? Same thing for our pastors. He's going to have to teach us things, Bible principles, so we can learn how to operate these principles in our own lives. You get what I'm saying? So let's not be afraid, folks, all right? Christ want to give you some money, man. Okay, I understand you're probably looking at the other side, you know, and Christ never told us to do that. He never told us to base what's going on the world system side, what they're doing with their money, okay, and base it upon what we're going to do with the money. No, you have a purpose. Christ's going to give you options on what to do with the money, okay? He needs millionaires, billionaires in the body of Christ moving the gospel, all right? That's what he wants. Okay, so we can help the poor, all right? So we can help them. And for those of us who are at the bottom, don't be discouraged. And you go to a prosperity church and you are at the bottom, okay? Don't be discouraged, because our bottom, being at the bottom, is only so we can appreciate the top, man. Okay, if we're doing the right thing. Christ gave you a vision, gave you a purpose, gave you a plan, then you're supposed to. I pray that you know the word on prosperity so Christ can channel this money through you. Okay, we are distribution centers. You got it? We're distribution centers, all right? It's going to channel the money through us, all right? It's like waters. Plumbers use pipes. Electricians use wires. You know what I'm saying? God uses man, all right, to get the message out to the people, all right? And you're going to need it, man. Proverbs chapter 13, verse 22, the wealth of the sinner is laid up for the just. What is the just? Righteous people, right standings with God, people, all right? We're going into the mainstream, people. We're going to need money, all right? Yes, need. NEED. That's what we're going to need, all right? So we can help this world get to where they need to be financially, okay? And get them out of this recession, all right? People are chasing the money because they have no understanding on how to get it the right way, all right? All right, if you like this video, please subscribe to my video channel at the bottom there, New Creature Speaks, okay? And I'll see you guys on the next video, all right? This is Don't Be Afraid of Money, right? And you have a great one, all right, as I will. I hope this message bless your life. And Christians, come out of that fear. We don't belong there. If you serve and obey, you spend your days in prosperity, years in pleasure. That pleasure does not mean pleasures of sin. It means pleasures of righteousness. Righteousness is right standings with God, all right? All right, y'all, I'm New Creature. I'm out. I'll see y'all next video. Later.